I've been using my Windows 11 phone-based computer from the last video over the past week in both handheld mode and in the desktop setup. I've been testing out the operating system by trying various apps and even some games, which has been the biggest disappointment. But this whole process has helped me find out more about Windows 11 and experience what it's like to use. I haven't used Windows 10 much since it was released, so the learning curve has been a little bit steeper for me. Now, something I've been interested in trying out is the x86 32 and 64-bit CPU emulation, and the compatibility when running that software on the ARM CPU. When Microsoft announced the 64-bit emulation for the Windows 10 preview, and the Lumia Windows on ARM project offered an intriguing way to try this out last year, I started looking for a Lumia 950XL secondhand. And just as Microsoft shifted their 64-bit emulation from Windows 10 on ARM over to Windows 11 on ARM at the end of 2021, I was finally able to find this white Lumia 950XL for a good price. This is the final model of Lumia that Microsoft made, originally released in the futuristic year of 2015. It's worth noting that I'm running a developer preview of Windows 11 on ARM, with an experimental test version of emulation support. Nothing I'm demonstrating in this video is fully representative of Windows 11, or Windows 11 on ARM, or the x86 64-bit emulation experience. It just gives an indication of what it's like, and it's my way of trying out Windows 11 for the first time. The Lumia Windows on ARM project supports the hardware really well, with the only partial support being the cellular and GPU aspects of the hardware. The cameras are not supported at all, though I was pleased to find the inbuilt FM radio fully working. Not sure what I would use this for, but I'm amused that I can listen to the radio using Windows 11 on my phone. The first software I tried out was Microsoft's included ARM version of their Edge browser. Despite running on a phone from 2015, I found the experience to be pretty good. Browsing YouTube was fine, and playing videos looked pretty good. Next, I installed Google Chrome on here, and there's only an x86 64-bit version of Google Chrome. There's no ARM version for Windows yet, due to some politics between Microsoft and Google, and maybe Qualcomm as well. But this is a good way to start testing out the 64-bit emulation support. As expected, it didn't run as well as Edge. In fact, it was quite sluggish at times, and I wasn't able to play full HD video. It wasn't until I dropped it all the way down to 480p that I started to get something watchable. Overall though, I'm pretty impressed with the compatibility, and running on a faster ARM CPU, I'm sure this would be quite usable, but if you're going to be running a web browser, you're going to be much better off just running a native ARM version. Next up, I wanted to try some local video playback, so I installed the 64-bit version of Media Player Classic. Again, I'm quite pleased that everything seems to run fine, and again, as expected, playback is kind of choppy. So I thought I'd compare this to VLC, which I'd read had an ARM version in the Microsoft Store. But when I installed it, it was even worse than Media Player Classic. So I had a look in the Task Manager, and it turns out I'd installed the x86 64-bit version. So I had to go back to the Microsoft Store, and it turns out you need to install VLC, the UWP version. It's quite a different version with a lot less options in it, but it is native ARM. I can now play back 1080p video really smoothly. It's going to be interesting to see what the future holds for Windows on ARM.
Future. Unbelievable. I gotta check this out, Doc.
Well, in good time, Marty. We're on a tight schedule here.
Now, before I get into games and the troubles I've been having with that, I did find some benchmarking software from Passmark, and they have both an ARM version and an x86 64-bit version of their benchmarking software. Running the 64-bit version did have some glitches though. When it came time to run the compression test and the CPU single-threaded test, both of those aborted during the test and Passmark gave no results. After that test was done and I uninstalled the 64-bit version, I then installed the ARM version and reran all the tests. and the results are kind of interesting. When doing a comparison with the other software, I can see the integer calculations are fairly similar, and this might be because there's not a lot of translation that needs to be done when emulating integer calculations. But some of the other results are quite different. For example, encryption is almost 10 times faster when running the native ARM benchmark. So you may have seen at the end of the last video, I did install Steam on here. Now I was hoping to have more success with games, but as it turned out, I couldn't really get any to run at all. Most games wouldn't even start on here. I also had a look at the very small number of games available in the Microsoft Store, and the selection seems quite dubious indeed. If one of the featured sections is casino games, I'm not sure that I'm going to find very many interesting games. I did end up trying one random game that installed okay, but when it comes time to actually start the game, it does crash. So I think the problems I'm having with games is the lack of a good GPU and partial support in the drivers, and so there's just a general lack of graphical features. So I think this is a big reason why I was unable to get games running on here, despite the fairly decent 64-bit emulation support. And I did install Microsoft's OpenCL and OpenGL compatibility pack, but I kept getting errors with Vulkan drivers and OpenGL errors, and it seems like there's many graphics modes that are just not well supported on here. So to confirm this is not really related to the 64-bit emulation support, I did try installing and running the ARM version of Doom 3, and even that failed to run due to OpenGL graphics problems. But I'm also quite interested in running retro games on here, which may not be as demanding on the graphics systems as newer games. I did try running Sim Earth on here, which uses DOSBox, so I'm certain that things like Doom would run on here using virtual machines like DOSBox. But I'm interested to see what sort of compatibility I can get running the original versions of games without ports or mods or any virtual machines underneath them. It turns out the earliest game that I found that runs in its original configuration is FreeCell. And this is one of Microsoft's first 32-bit applications, which they use for testing 32-bit support in Windows 3.1. And this game runs fine with all its original code while being emulated on the ARM CPU. Some other early games that run fine with their original code are Pinball, and this is a really fun game to play. And another one I found is Nanocore, and this is a sort of an early 3D type game. But I'm having a bit of trouble on here with the controls at the moment. So for many retro games, you will need to experiment with various ways to get them to work. And I expect many games from the early Windows era are going to need a lot of modification to run. I was pleased to find that ScummVM does run on here. I tried out one of my favourite games, Blade Runner from 1997. Unfortunately, it didn't run particularly well. And I did try both the 32-bit version of ScummVM and compared it to the 64-bit version of ScummVM. And I noticed the 64-bit version was a little bit slower. I guess that's to be expected with the emulation engine doing a little bit more work with the 64-bit software. So digging a little bit deeper, I did find someone on GitHub who had compiled a Windows ARM version of ScummVM. It's an earlier version of ScummVM, but it does support the Blade Runner game. And I'm pleased to report that this version of ScummVM runs really well on here. And with that, I finally reached the future. I hope you're enjoying this channel. Hopefully soon, I will get back to the past with some more retro technology. Until then, thank you for watching, sharing, commenting, and enjoying these videos. See you next time.